Coffee may not be the top consumed beverage in the world, but it does have its ardent group of drinkers. It consists of several bioactive compounds, which are healthy for our body. For instance, kahweol and cafestol present are found in unfiltered coffee. They are natural oils present in coffee and can protect against cancer. However, if taken excessively, it will lead to a rise in LDL. Excessive of anything is abuse and cause problems. Which ingredient in coffee stimulates the brain? One of the main ingredients in coffee is caffeine, and this is what is responsible for stimulating the central nervous system. It happens to be one of the most consumed psychoactive substances in the world. Caffeine falls under the same category of drugs which are considered as psychostimulants, such as Ritalin, cocaine, and methamphetamine. Caffeine is a very mind stimulant, and drinking more of it is not considered as drug abuse, but it definitely is addictive. Positive effects of coffee on the brain. Once you drink coffee, it takes 1 hour for it to reach its highest level, and stays at this point for up to 6 hours. It acts on the neurotransmitter known as adenosine, which is responsible for alertness, attention, and sleep. The caffeine blocks the adenosine and doesn't make you sleepy. This keeps you alert. Students say that consuming 160 to 600 milligrams of caffeine improves reasoning, mental alertness, and sharpens the memory. When caffeine blocks adenosine, the hormones of glutamate and dopamine flow freely, so you are not only alert, but also show bettered mental performance and feel energetic. Caffeine also helps in increasing the serotonin, which is known for bringing positivity in you. Caffeine also comprises of certain compound known as polyphenol, which is antioxidant. Polyphenol is responsible for proper functioning of the brain. The age-related cognitive and psychological decline is slowed down with caffeine. In a way, caffeine helps in avoiding diseases associated with the brain, such as Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. Drinking coffee after an individual has had a learning session helps in retaining what one has learned from the session. Coffee also releases adrenaline, or epinephrine, which is a hormone and a neurotransmitter. It is connected with fight or flight response to a situation. But when stimulated because of caffeine, it instantly energizes your body. Negative effects of coffee on brain. Caffeine intake has some negative issues, such as sleeplessness. Someone who continually drinks coffee gets addicted to it, and later suffers from disrupted sleep, even after lowering coffee intake. This finally leads to continuous headaches. Some researchers show that caffeine may block the hormone that helps in keeping the arteries wide enough for proper flow of blood. This leads to high blood pressure. Excessive intake of coffee causes coffee intoxication. This leads to symptoms such as insomnia, muscle tremor, headache, heart palpitations, irritability, etc. Coffee is tasty, and it does give us the energy to remain fresh during the day, yet it should be taken in a controlled way. It could be harmful if one consumes too much of it.